Okay, we are now on Friday, so day two of Warbirds and Classics over Michigan 2023. First victim of the day, RJ Monroe, which I believe this is a Aeroworks Cessna 195, originally an ARF, that he has stripped and covered in fabric and painted. Looks real nice. And of course, we do have a crosswind today. Still won't bounce. Okay. I even offered him money. Wouldn't do it. Beautiful. Yeehaw.
We got anything going out. Are you okay?
I'm okay. Okay. Yeah, bring it in.
Oh, we got a dead engine.
Right engine, David.
to her, buddy.
Everybody's clear. Field's all yours.
Beach handles like a baby on one engine, Dave. Easy, easy, easy. It's like riding a bike.
Start going right to the cannon open field. There you go.
Nice job, Dave. Nice save.
Landing on one. Landing.
A Fokker.
Morning, Andy.
Morning. This is one of the new ones, right?
Yes.
Perfect. Balsa USA Eindecker DLE 20. No better combo. Fly the plane for 4 years on 1 gallon of gas.
True story.
Yep. And we got Mr. P40 Rich Eggleston, scared everybody out of the sky. that's how you land a Waco.
You like that, Andy?
I like that.
Thank you. Good for the first one of the year.
Yeah.
Better than the takeoff.
Whoops. Look, little touch and go. Why not? Got to get those touch and goes out of the way.
Behind you.
We're gonna do a half a lap.
Okay.
You're all right.
There's the guy that stole all my roof flashers. Covered his P51 in it. Chuck's gonna be happy all day. Looks like my neighbor's going up the fly. Oh, ground loopy, ground loopy. Oh, bummer. That wasn't Gary Landon, was it?
Hey.
Hey, we're wearing the same shirt. I can give him all the shit I want.
Yes,
looks good, buddy.
clear pass next time around.
Denied.
Okay.
Bombers going up, four B-25s and a Douglas A-20. American Eagle B-25. Very, very rare these days. Popular kit about 100 years ago. Firewall them bad boys. Hopefully you can see what's going on, just trying to keep them all in the frame here. It's not easy getting a bunch of twins with all different power plants to line up. Frankie likes to do the high approach and use the excessive drag to slow her down. Works every time. Dead stick about to happen. I think that engine's just barely running. That's all she had. Typical no bounce gym rep touchdown. Yes. Yes.
Flutter the rudders off? No.
Chris, I'll give you five.
Like a half inch of play with the radio on.
That's fine.
Don't we do loops and stuff?
Chris, I'll give you $5.
I think there's.
Little floaty, floaty formation.
Probably got to retrim the flaps too.
There's three and nothing fell off. Hell yeah.
this thing landing. Oh,
I love it. He's farting with that canopy. I told him I glue it on. I agree. Thank you. old best buddy in the world, Kirk Wheeler, has come back to Warbirds over Michigan just to fly with me. I am tickled pink. Nice job, Bob.
Well done.
Nice. Looked good though. I liked it.
Excellent.
See, we mow it down there for a reason.
Thank goodness.
Dead Coffin.
Go.
Thank you.
like the Doolittle Raiders.
Exactly.
Except we're on the wrong side, though. Plane that does not bounce. Hold on to her there, Frankie.
There you go.
Nice. Oh, still flying, Frankie. Still flying. Ah.
That was a bump. That's the same bump I hit.
Hey, Frankie, thank you. We don't need no stinking runway. I think he's enjoying that a little too much. Absolutely not. Go around. Oh. No. Oh, boy. Wow.
Yeah, I know.
That was a good choice, just a little too late.
Hey, you coming in?
That's better. I mean, the first one was cooler, but that was better. Yeah, that's got the Spicala spar in it. Perfect. Oh yeah.
Because there's dihedral in here,
yeah.
I should take a wing off and show you. I made these cam lobes that are on the spar.
Yep.
And it's like the lobes on a cam of an engine.
I know.
So
yeah.
Out yep. Further, the lobe is down low, yeah. And inside the lobe is up high. And you have to fit the spar in there only one way, and the lobes on one side don't fit the other because
wow.
It was built, you know, before I
sure.
Had a spar. But, you know, with this here, it gives you great confidence, and I don't have any
bridge. It didn't give us a bit of confidence.
I don't have any bridger bar across here at all.
I see that.
And I'll tell you what, those wings aren't going anywhere.
No. We believe you.
Yeah.
Yeah, you proved your point.
That's for sure.
Okay, everybody. So, as most of you know, I also have been flying the FR Sky equipment recently with their new Tandem Series radios. I'm still a Futaba man, Airtronics man, sticking with them. But the Free Sky is really good quality stuff. And right now I'm talking with my good buddy, Leo Spicala. I've known Leo and Zach for a long time, and they have recently been using the Free Sky, but yeah, they just informed me that they are now exclusively using Free Sky.
We're 100% Free Sky now this year. So we were Spectrum, and last year we bought some of the X20S, and we just gave them a try, tried them out in some Giants, some Gassers, some Foamies. We had really good performance. We liked the systems. We thought we've done some testing. The signal strength is superior in our opinion. So now we've moved into turbine jets with the FR Sky. So this is my second turbine conversion, and what I'm doing is running a tandem on here. I've got both 2.4 and the 900 megahertz systems, and I'm running redundancy. I actually have four receivers that are running the whole airplane, two separate systems. The 2.4 runs as like the main receiver, and then I have ganged together, I have an R9 Pro that runs into the R8, and what that does is it acts like a satellite and gives me the 900 megahertz as well. So
far you'd say the modern Free Sky, as far as the Tandem series, is a keeper.
Yeah, it's a keeper. We've been encouraged, and you can activate a data logger on here and log each and every one of your flights, and then download the data to a spreadsheet and analyze your signal strength. And in some cases we moved a few antennas around in order to give us a little bit more antenna diversity, but not too much. And they've been fantastic. We're seeing that the signal strength actually varies depending on what model airplane field you fly at.
Oh yeah, I believe it.
You can get interference from the local atmosphere on either 2.4 or 900. So sometimes the 900 is stronger, sometimes the 2.4 is stronger.
Yep.
But either way, we got the confidence that we got the signal.
Fantastic. All right, I thank you for your time, Leo.
Yep.
And showing us how you can flex the wings on a Panther.
Yeah, gotta have a spar. Okay, thank you.
All right, thanks. Yep. Nose down, nose down, nose down. Wow, fantastic. Woo!
Powerhouse.
couple things like a full-size airplane isn't handy.
Oh yeah, beautiful. Oh, okay.
He bought an engine and got it. Well, he bought an airframe and got that engine.
Yeah.
Now he's got about three of those Sato 60 R3s.
He's a glutton for punishment, he is. Okay. That'll do, pig. That'll do.
That'll be beautiful.
Giggity, giggity, giggity.
Actually, would touch building bells.
Yes, I would. Now that's a
man behind the camera.
Lights, camera, action!
Thank you.
having my landing light on my Oscars, and, you know, I just, Timmy, I got it on a slider, depending on where I put it, I can have it full, blinking, blink, 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 and stuff.
Popped a muffler.
At least